Hi, I'm Matthew Doyle, Technical Marketing Specialist at Autodesk Scaleform. In this video, I'll be going over the best way to quickly get you started with Scaleform, the industry-leading cross-platform, Flash-based UI SDK. Getting started with Scaleform is easy. Once you've set up your developer account, simply download and install the SDK files with the links provided. You may also wish to download and install the various Scaleform UI kits at this time, such as the Menu Kit and MMO Kit. These kits were built using best practice construction techniques, using production-level code and assets, and demonstrate how your UI team might want to build the respective UIs. For more general information on these kits, please watch their respective videos, available to watch at scaleform.com/features. If you've also purchased either the Scaleform IME system or Scaleform Video, be sure to download and install those products as well. For more information on using Scaleform IME or Scaleform Video, please see their respective videos and documentation. Once you've installed the SDK, you'll want to have a look at the Scaleform SDK browser. There should be a shortcut on your desktop. If not, you'll find a shortcut in the Scaleform SDK folder on your Start menu in Windows. The SDK browser can be viewed in English, Japanese, Korean, or Chinese, both simplified and traditional. The first page of the browser, Getting Started, provides an overview of the latest cool features in Scaleform, as well as links to documents and samples of those features. At the bottom, you'll find a direct link to the technical support ticketing system and the developers forums. The programs page is divided into two tabs. The first tab provides resource and solution links to the various Scaleform players. The tools tab provides links to Scaleform tools such as AMP, our content profiling application, GFX export, which is used to batch export textures into DDS format, among other things, and our video encoder for creating Scaleform compatible videos. The video encoder entry will only be present if you've downloaded and installed the optional Scaleform video package. We'll cover AMP briefly a bit later in the video. GFX export is a command line utility. It will convert flash files into Scaleform GFX format, which is optimized for streamlined loading, as well as extracting and optimizing textures and fonts. For details on how to use it, check out the reference guide. Scaleform's video encoder is covered in the Getting Started with Scaleform Video document. The ActionScript 2 and 3 pages are composed of three tabs. The first tab is the Samples tab, where various UI demos and samples can be found. The Kits tab provides resource, solution, and document links to the various UI kits, such as the HUD kit, menu kit, and MMO kit. Last of all, the third tab provides links to UI widget samples created using Click. Click is Scaleform's UI widget framework, designed for rapidly creating fully featured UIs that are optimized for performance and easily skinned. It comes in both ActionScript 2 and ActionScript 3 varieties. The final page of the SDK browser is the Help page. It contains tabs for tutorials and documentation on all aspects of Scaleform. Be sure to read the Getting Started guide as one of your first steps in learning Scaleform. Now that you're familiar with the SDK browser, the next thing to do is to set up the Adobe Flash IDE for Scaleform development. First, you'll need to set up the Click class paths. Let's start by setting up the class paths for ActionScript 2. Click Edit in the top menu. Select Preferences from the dropdown. Select ActionScript from the category area. Click the ActionScript 2.0 Settings button near the bottom. In the ActionScript 2.0 Settings window, press the Add New Path icon. The looks of this icon varies from Flash version to Flash version. In CS5, the icon will be a blue plus symbol. With the new entry selected, press the Browse to Path icon to open a file browser. Browse to C:\Program Files. On 64-bit operating systems, browse to Program Files x86. Now find the Scaleform folder and open it. Inside the Scaleform folder, open the GFX SDK folder, which will have your version number. Then open the Resources folder inside. And finally, open the AS2 folder. Select the Click folder by clicking on it once. Then press OK. With the new entry selected, press the Move Path Up icon so that the entry is beneath the single dot entry, but above the Local Data Classes entry. Press OK. Next, let's set up the class paths for ActionScript 3. This procedure is very similar. This time, press the ActionScript 3.0 Settings button. In the Source Path section of the ActionScript 3.0 Advanced Settings window, press the Add New Path icon. With the new entry selected, press the Browse to Path icon. This time, browse to the AS3 folder inside your Scaleform GFX SDK Resources folder and open it. Select the Click directory and press OK. Press OK to close the AS3 Advanced Settings window. Then press OK to close the Preferences window. Next up is the Scaleform Launcher. Installing the Scaleform Launcher Flash extension will allow you to publish your content straight to Scaleform's hardware accelerated player for testing your content outside of the game engine. The external Scaleform player will give you a virtually identical view of your content as you would expect to see it functioning in-game. In Flash, click Help in the top menu and select Manage Extensions. This brings up the Adobe Extension Manager. Alternatively, you can launch the manager from the Adobe folder in your Start menu. Press the Install button at the top of the Extensions Manager. Browse to the Resources folder in your Scaleform Install. In the Tools folder, you'll find the file scaleformextensions.mxp. Select this file and press Open. This will begin the install process, which only takes a few seconds. Answer in the affirmative for any dialogs that pop up during the install. Once the launcher is installed, you'll need to shut down Flash and restart it. Now that the launcher is installed, you can open it by selecting Window in the top menu, then Other Panels. Feel free to dock the launcher panel somewhere convenient. Before we can use the launcher, we need to create a new player profile. To do this, click the plus button at the bottom right of the launcher panel. In the pop-up window, click the plus button again. This time it's to the right of the Player EXE dropdown. Browse to your Scaleform install again, this time going into the Bin folder. In the Bin folder, you'll find gfxmediaplayer.exe. This is the standard shipping Scaleform player that comes with the SDK. You can build other versions of the player, but that topic is beyond the scope of this tutorial. Select gfxmediaplayer.exe and press Open. In the prompt window, you can either leave the name as is or name it something more descriptive. I like to name mine based on the installed SDK version. In this case, 4.0.13. Your new player EXE should now be available in the dropdown. Give the profile a descriptive name. Press OK. This will return you to the main launcher panel. Let's test out our player profile. Open the click-tutorial-skinned.fla file found in the Resources AS2 Click Tutorial directory of your Scaleform SDK install. This simple menu was built entirely using Scaleform Click and skinned with Adobe Photoshop. Now press the Test With button in the Scaleform launcher. When the Scaleform player launches, it will launch two windows. The main window displays your Flash content as designed. The title bar tells you which renderer it's using, in this case Direct 3D9, and the version of your Scaleform SDK. The second window displays log information, errors, and Flash trace statements that you put in your file. In the Scaleform player window, there are a number of things you can do. First off, pressing F1 will toggle the list of shortcut keys. Pressing Ctrl and F will bring up basic performance metrics in the title bar. Let's take note of some of the metrics. First up is FPS, or frame rate. Next, in parentheses, is number of meshes, number of draw primitives, and total number of triangles being drawn. After this is A, D, and O. A stands for advance. This tracks how many milliseconds are required for code execution to occur on any given frame. D stands for display, and this tracks how many milliseconds is taking to render any given frame. Finally, O, or other, tracks additional time used by Scaleform outside of advance and display. Pressing Ctrl and F again will toggle the metrics off. Ctrl W will toggle wireframe mode. It is in wireframe mode that we can see how Scaleform is taking the 2D UI elements and tessellating them into triangles. Ctrl A will cycle through the different anti-aliasing modes. First, let's press F2 to get some playback info so we can see what AA mode we're in. Now we can cycle through AA modes with Ctrl A. The modes are Edge AA, HWFS AA, or Hardware Full Screen Anti-Aliasing, and None or No Anti-Aliasing. Ctrl E toggles the Overdraw Display mode. Green indicates low or no overdraw, with brighter levels of green indicating higher overdraw. Red indicates masks, which can be expensive on some platforms, and blue indicates filters, which can also be expensive on some platforms. The three colors are additive, mixing together if they overlap. Therefore, anytime you see bright yellow, you know you've got excessive overdraw. Keeping your overdraw low is important to maintaining high performance on some platforms. Control-J toggles the Intelligent Batching Display mode, which indicates how the UI elements are being batched together at runtime to reduce draw primitives, another key factor in performance. Objects which are the same color in the display mode have been added to the same batch. Objects that are different colors are in different batches and thus different draw primitives. The last item we'll cover is Control-R, which restarts the flash movie. There are a number of other toggles and options found in the keyboard shortcut menu, which you should try out. The Scaleform SDK provides a fully featured profiling tool named AMP, or Analyzer for Memory and Performance. Let's launch AMP from the SDK browser. The first window is populated by links to all the machines on the network which are currently running AMP servers, such as the Scaleform Player application. Each link provides basic details about that machine, including the IP address, as well as the title and version of the Scaleform Player, the machine type, and the name of the file being profiled. Simply clicking on one of the machines will begin profiling that content. AMP was designed to be UI artist friendly, allowing the artist to profile their Flash content without necessarily needing to get an engineer involved. AMP provides access to all the same functionality in the Scaleform Player, such as wireframe mode, overdraw, and intelligent batching display. But AMP's greatest value is its ability to profile CPU, memory, and rendering performance via real-time display graphs. Each graph tracks data to that category in real time as it occurs. At the bottom of the window, you'll find more details for each graph via tabbed windows. For more details on using AMP, please refer to the AMP User Guide or the AMP Use Case document. You can also check out our AMP webcast, which goes over AMP in considerable detail. As a programmer, the first places you'll likely want to look into are the lib and include folders, which are needed for adding Scaleform to your game code. The folders are located at the top level of your Scaleform install folder and exist for each platform that you've downloaded. Next, have a look at the samples project found in Projects, Win32, MSVC90, Samples. Double-click the file gfx4.0demos.solution to open it. The solution includes several Scaleform use case demos, such as Draw Text, Swift to Texture, Texture in Swift, and Tiny Player. The Draw Text demo demonstrates how to use the Draw Text API, while Swift to Texture and Texture in Swift demonstrate various render texture possibilities. Tiny Player is the smallest and simplest application, which demonstrates how Scaleform can be easily used in a single-threaded environment. You'll also benefit from the integration tutorial solution found in Apps Tutorial. The tutorial is composed of multiple sections, each one building off the next and growing in complexity. It goes over typical integration steps in greater detail using a D3D9 application as an example. This solution comes with supporting documentation, which can be found in the Tutorials tab on the Help page of the SDK browser. If you ever run into a trouble spot while using Scaleform, we provide AAA support. The best way to get help is via our ticketing system on the website. From the Developer Center, click on My Tickets. Fill out the pertinent information and click the Submit Ticket button. That's all there is to it. Your support requests will be assigned to the right person on the team to handle the job, and we'll get back to you as quickly as we can. Autodesk Scaleform is committed to helping you learn as well. On top of our full documentation, we also provide great video tutorials, as well as webinars and webcasts. Videos are accessible from the Developer Center via the Videos menu item, as well as on our YouTube channel, Scaleform Press. You can sign up for webinars at scaleform.com/joinwebinar. We hope you'll find the Scaleform SDK a powerful tool for developing next-gen UIs. Thank you for watching.